Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Shubham and today I'm going to talk about a very important topic, that is scabies. Okay, so scabies, if you talk about, then this is a itchy condition, right? So scabies is a itchy mite. Okay, scabies is a itchy contagious, again, right? Contagious ectoparasitic skin infestation. Okay, ectoparasitic skin infestation. So that is the scabies. So whenever the patient is coming to your OPD, okay, then the patient is complaining of usually the itchy kind of papules. Okay, we'll talk about that, what is papules and all. So basic thing is, the person is complaining of the itching. Basically it is pruritic and it is a contagious, it spreads actually. So causative agent over here is the itch mite. Okay, very important. So what is the causative agent? Okay, so causative agent which is causing the scabies, that is the itch mite. And this itch mite, we are calling this itch mite as your Sarcoptes scabie, right? Sarcoptes scabie, right? That is the itch mite which is responsible for causing the scabies, right? Sarcoptes scabie var hominis. Okay, as you have studied in the parasitology as well. Okay, so that is the causative agent over here. Okay, I will show you how the Sarcoptes scabie look and all. So that is the thing basically. Okay, if you talk about number of mite usually per patient, if I'm saying on an average, I'm saying generally, so 11 to 13 mites can be present per patient. Okay, so if you talk about the number of mites, I mean the Sarcoptes scabie. Okay, so 11 to 13 mites per patient might be found. Okay, so 11 to 13 mites per patient might be found. Okay, might be found over there, fine. And you know, as I said, this is the contagious, so it will be spreading from one person to another. So that means personal skin contact, okay, that is responsible for spreading the scabies basically. Okay, that is the basic thing, I'm not writing about that. And it is also called as the water wash disease, very important. It is also called as the water wash disease because most of the patient you will be seeing in your OPD for the scabies, they will be having the complaining of the itchiness and all, and most of them, they are not maintaining the personal hygiene over there. Okay, so if the person is not maintaining the personal hygiene, in that case the Sarcoptes scabie, that is the itch mite, is having more chances to to stick to the body of such persons, right? So it is also called a water wash disease, basically that if the person is maintaining the personal hygiene or regularly taking baths and all, so the person will be having the lesser chances comparatively of getting the scabies, right? Okay, so what, that's why it is called as water wash disease, because of the hygiene component, right? Now next thing over here I would like to include over here is that if you talk about the history of such patient, they will be saying that at the night time usually they are not able to sleep because of the severe itch present over there, because at the night time the Sarcoptes scabie itch mite, okay, this is coming into action and causing severe itch in the patients. Okay, so usually the patients are saying that they are not able to sleep properly at the night, so that's why nocturnal pruritus. Okay, what I'm using the term over here, I'm using the important term over here, that is the nocturnal pruritus will be the history of the patient. So if you will be asking them, so nocturnal pruritus means at the night time they will be saying the complaints of itch basically, right? Family history might be important so you need to take the history of the family as well, because as I said, this is contagious, so it can spread from one family member to another one as well, right? What about very important clinical features? Okay, what about the clinical features in this case? Okay, if you talk about the clinical features, then first one is the papules. Okay, excoriated papules can be seen, right? Excoriated papules can be seen. What do I mean by excoriated papules? Just look over the screen right now. Over here you can see small small papules over here, isn't it? Small small papules. For example, look over this one, right? Look over this papule over here, look over this papule, look over this papule, right? Okay, so what are the papules? These are just flat kind of lesions. Okay, this is the primary lesion basically. These are flat lesions. And what are the excoriations? While scratching, because they will be having the severe itch over there at these particular papules over there. So while scratching, they might be having some excoriations, as you might see some dots over there, some red color dots you can see over here. Okay, I hope you are able to see them, right? So some kind of dots you can see over there. These are the excoriations present over these papules. So these are the excoriated papules. This kind of manifestation can be seen in your patient. So first one. Second one I would like to include over here is, that is the Burrow lesions. Okay, what do I mean by that? Okay, that is the Burrow lesions. Now Burrow lesions means, you know, serpiginous tunnel might be present over there. What I said, serpiginous kind of tunnel. Okay, in the skin, obviously. In the skin, basically the stratum corneum, the superficial, most superficial layer of the epidermis is involved over there. Okay, so what do I mean by serpiginous tunnel? Look over here. As you can see, serpiginous means snake, right? Snake kind of pattern you'll be seeing over here. As you can see with the black arrows, very clearly you can see over here that, you know, this kind of pattern is seen over there like a snake. Okay, so this kind of pattern you can see over here like a snake over there. So this kind of pattern is seen because, you know, the Sarcoptes KB is just entering into the skin, most superficial layer of the skin, and making a tunnel kind of thing over here. Okay, what do I mean by that? For example, if this is the epidermis, right, this is the epidermis, and underlying layer is the dermis. Okay, underlying layer is the dermis over here. As you know that epidermis, five layers are there in the epidermis, right? Stratum corneum, stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, stratum basale, right? So five layers are there. Superficial most layer is the stratum corneum. Okay, superficial most layer is the stratum corneum. So what will be happening? Okay, let's say this is the stratum corneum layer, right? This is the stratum corneum. Above it, there is a stratum corneum. So what the Sarcoptes KB, that itch mite, what it will be doing over there is that it will be entering from the skin. Okay, it will be entering into the skin and then it will be moving like this. Okay, then it will be moving like this. So that's why it will be forming a serpiginous tunnel kind of thing over the superficial layer of the skin. Okay, so Sarcoptes KB is just moving like that. So that's why it is having the serpiginous tunnel kind of pattern. So that is called as a burrow. It is making a burrow over there. That's why it is called as a burrow lesion. So two things: excoriated papules and the burrow lesions, guys. Okay, third thing over here I would like to include, that is, okay, the site. The site, if you talk about what are the site basically, then I will be talking about the web spaces. Very important, I'm talking about the web spaces, because very commonly it is involving the web spaces. What are the web spaces? Between the fingers, between the toes. Okay, these are the spaces over there, right? Between the fingers. For example, look over this image, guys. Yes, what you can see over here. Okay, what you can see over here, look, web spaces. Look at the web spaces over here, everybody. Look at the web spaces. Yes, you can see the, you know, some kind of papules are there, some kind of little vesicles can be seen over there. Okay, so these are your scabies, right? These are your excoriated papules can be seen over there. Okay, serpiginous tunnel can be seen over there. For example, this one, right? So this is what, this is the scabies basically, right? So present in the web spaces, I mean. So three things over there: excoriated papules, burrow lesions, and the sites are the web spaces. Very commonly it is involved. Okay, so whenever the patient comes, don't just look for these kind of things: excoriated papules, burrow lesions, sites, web spaces usually. So first of all, we are seeing usually the web spaces because they are involved taking the history, that nocturnal itch is there. Okay, and straight away you can make your diagnosis over there. Okay, so don't miss out on these things, right? Then if you talk about the distribution, how the scabies lesions are actually spreading themselves, and what can be the other sites. I told you the web space is one of them. What can be the other sites? So, you know, just to remember the other sites, very simply you can remember them by the help of circle of Hebra. Okay, so if you talk about the distribution pattern, okay, if you talk about the distribution pattern of the Sarcoptes KB mite, okay, scabies, okay, then you will be seeing the circle of Hebra. What do I mean by circle of Hebra now? Circle of Hebra you can see over here right now on your screen. Okay, what you can see right now on your screen, guys. So look, first of all, I told you that web spaces are involved. Okay, I told you that web spaces are involved. So yes, this one, first one, your web spaces are involved, fine. Second one, medial aspect of the forearm can be involved. Okay, what I said, medial aspect of the forearm and the arm. So second one is this one, right? Okay, so this is the first point, this is the second point. Okay, third point, your axillary region can be involved. So this is the axilla, so this is the third one, right? Then after the axilla, your periareolar region, that is near the nipple. Okay, this region, this one I am talking about. Okay, this area I am talking about. So periareolar region of the nipple can be involved. So over here I am just making a dot. So this can also be involved over there. Okay, after that, umbilical region, umbilicus region. So here the umbilicus, so umbilical region can be involved. So that will be the fifth one. Okay, fifth one, umbilical region can be involved. Then the genitals can be involved. So genitals are present over here, right? So sixth, genitals can be involved. And then the groin region can be involved, right? The groin region can be involved, that is your seventh. Okay, what you need to do now, you just need to join the dots. Just need to join the dots. So if you will be meeting up the dots over there, okay, just join the dots over there, what you'll be finding, you'll be finding that you can make a circle over there, isn't it? This is what, guys, circle of Hebra. Understood? Easy, isn't it? So it is the circle of Hebra which can be present in, which can be found in the scabies. Okay, so with the help of circle of Hebra, easily you can remember the distribution pattern of the scabies. So whenever the patient comes, don't miss out on these kind of presentation. For example, you need to ask the history, nocturnal history, then talking about the web spaces. After the web spaces, what can be the things which can be involved over there as far as body is concerned, then medial aspect of forearm, axillary region, periareolar region, umbilical region, genital region, and the groin region. Okay, if you will join the dot, that is a circle of Hebra. Understood? No doubt about it. Okay, so distribution by the help of circle of Hebra, definitely. So I'm just writing over here, circle of Hebra. That is actually signifying and helping us to remember the important sites for the Sarcoptes scabie, most likely sites, I would say. Face is usually spared in this. I haven't talked about the face over here. Face is usually spared in the scabies patient. Okay, further I will be telling you the scabie, if the scabies is present in the infants, then it can involve the face also. But in the adults, as far as adults are concerned, face is usually not involved by the scabies, right? Okay, that is about the about the distribution pattern. If you talk about the investigation part, okay, if you talk about the investigations, what investigation you will be doing over there? So for most of the fungal infections and for most of the parasitic infection, this is also the parasitic infection, basically we are doing a very important test over there, that is the KOH mount. Okay, what we are doing actually, that is the KOH mount, potassium hydroxide mount. In the potassium hydroxide mount, what we'll be seeing actually, we can see the mite, which is the Sarcoptes scabie, right? Then we can see the eggs of the Sarcoptes scabie, each mite, and then we can see some of the fecal pellets over there. But how the Sarcoptes scabie look, that is important. Look at the picture right now, how the Sarcoptes scabie look. If you will see how to identify this, identification is very easy, guys. Identification is very easy. As you can see over here, just see the legs of the Sarcoptes scabie. This is the itch mite, obviously. So look over here. Okay, can you see one pair of leg? Two legs are there, one pair of leg on one side, one pair of leg on other side. So on the anterior portion, on the anterior side, there are, okay, you can see over there, two pairs. Okay, one pair is on the left side, one pair on the right side, two anterior pairs of legs are present. Posterior side, on the posterior side also, you will be seeing one pair of legs is present over here, one pair of legs is present over here. Okay, so what I can see over here, that two pairs of legs are present anteriorly as well as posteriorly. Okay, so that's how we are actually identifying the sarcoptes KB on the KOH mount, potassium hydroxide mount. Okay, I hope I am clear. I'm just writing over here that two anterior pair of legs and two posterior pair of legs can be found. Posterior pairs of legs can be found as far as sarcoptes KB is concerned, if you are identifying them in the KOH potassium hydroxide mount, right? Okay, we have talked about that much about the scabies. Okay, if you talk about the treatment of the scabies, investigation is fine. If you talk about the treatment part of the scabies, right, let's talk about the treatment part also. Investigation we have done, treatment part. So usually, generally, how we are managing the scabies patient, as I said, pruritus will be there. It is a pruritic itch mite, so itching will be there. For the itching part, we are giving the antihistamines. Obviously, itching will be there, so antihistamine should be given, right? Antihistamine should be given. As I said, it is contagious. So from one family member to the another family member, it can be spreading. Okay, so that's why anti-scabies drug we need to prescribe to the patient. What anti-scabies you will be prescribing, I will be just talking about that. Okay, then for the clothing part, so antihistamine you are giving, actually antihistamine we are giving, anti-scabies drug, for example, permethrin 5% we are giving. Permethrin 5% cream is there. Okay, we are giving, and for the, and we are saying that washing is very important. Antihistamine we are giving for the itching purpose, as it is, you know, very itchy. So that's why antihistamine has to be given for the pruritic part. Permethrin 5% topically we are giving. Okay, how to apply and all, I will talk about that. So that anti-scabies we are giving for the family members, because as it is contagious, so for contagiousness we are giving that. Okay, so for contagiousness we are giving that. So I mean, if the family members are involved, treat the family members as well. Okay, otherwise there is no use of treating one person in the family. If there are 2 to 3 family members are involved, there is no purpose for us to treat only one patient. We have to treat all of them, because it is contagious, so it can spread from one to another. Okay, washing is very important. So even if one person is involved, okay, we need to make sure that this person should not spread to other family members. So that's why personal hygiene part should be prioritized over here. So we need to actually make sure that this person is taking good personal hygiene for themselves. So, you know, washing and all, and proper iron of the cloth should be done over there, right? So washing for the purpose of this clothing part, basically. Okay, fine, everything is fine. Now permethrin 5%, we are applying it topically. So topical application is there. Okay, topically you are applying the permethrin 5%. Other kind of stuffs are also there. For example, benzyl benzoate cream is there, or crotamitone is there, but usually, most basically, we are prescribing the permethrin 5% cream very, very commonly in the OPD. Okay, easily available as well. So how to apply the permethrin 5%, if I'm talking about, so how to apply the permethrin 5%? Okay, for the permethrin 5%, what we are doing basically, that we are saying that apply this cream below the neck. Okay, what we are saying, apply this cream below the neck. Okay, half of the bottle should be applied topically over the body surface below the neck, not the face, because as I said that usually in the adults face is not involved, so we don't need to apply over the face. So below the neck region we are applying half of the bottle of that permethrin 5% cream. So okay, so half of the bottle should be applied over there, so below neck. Okay, application for about 12 hours. So usually we are telling them to apply it in the night time, as in the daytime it is not possible, person has to do other activity, daily activities as well. So in the night time, while the patient will be sleeping, okay, the person will be sleeping for about 8 to 12 hours. So for that time, the person will be having, you know, below the neck, the person will be having application for about 12 hours. Okay, entire body below neck. Okay, then after that the patient has to take a bath, obviously. Okay, and once the person has been applied for the 12 hours, okay, then wash it, then wash in the morning time usually. Okay, after that wait for 1 week. After one week person has to reapply rest half of the bottle, right? So first half of the bottle has to be applied on the first day. After 1 week the rest half of the bottle should be applied just like that below the neck only, right? And has to be applied over there for about 12 hours. Okay, and then again need to wash. So after 1 week again reapplication, right? Reapplication. So that's how we are actually instructing our patient to use the permethrin 5% cream. If the patient is not using in this manner, then the person is mistaking somewhere and scabies will not be able to treat at that time. Okay, so that's why instructing our patient about the permethrin 5% is very, very important for us, right? Okay, then as this is about the topical treatment, because the person will be just applying over the skin surface. But what about the systemic treatment if the person is not responding, for example? Or the systemic treatment, what is the thing which is available for us? So as far as systemic management is concerned, okay, as far as systemic management is concerned, then we can give actually ivermectin. Okay, and the dose will be about 200 microgram per kg. Okay, we can actually give the ivermectin 200 microgram per kg. Fine. Now we are having other special kind of scabies also, for example other types of scabies. So let's discuss the types of scabies. Okay, some special types of scabies also over here. So what are they? Okay, types of scabies. So first one over here, I would like to include the infantile scabies, guys. Infantile scabies. Now what do I mean by infantile scabies? Now infantile means obviously it will be happening in the infants only, as the name suggests. Two things are involved, as you can see on the screen also. Two things are involved. First is the face. Second one is the palms or soles. Okay, second one is the palms, either on palms, either on soles. So vesicles can be there, as you can see over here on the palms or soles region. As you can see over here, some of the vesicles are present over there, right? Some of the vesicles are present over there. What are the vesicles? Vesicles are the fluid filled lesions. Again, they are the primary lesions only. Vesicles are the fluid filled lesions less than 1 centimeter. Okay, so these are the vesicles. Then what you can see over here on the face, as I said, in the adults face is spared, but in the infants the face can be involved. If it is involved, then we are saying that it is the infantile scabies. Okay, so in this case we need to apply the permethrin 5% cream even on the face also. Okay, in the adults I was telling you that below the neck we need to apply it, but on the if the infantile scabies is there, we need to apply it on the face as well. As you can see, the lesions are present over the face also, right? Next kind of scabies we can see over there, that is the Norwegian, right? Norwegian scabies, you might have heard about that in your parasitology also, that Norwegian scabies. Now Norwegian scabies is the most severe form of the scabies. It is the most severe form of scabies, and usually it is happening in those patients who are immunosuppressed. And these patients who are immunosuppressed or immunocompromised, okay, then in these patients they are not feeling the itching over there. As I said, scabies is usually the itch mite is causing that, so it is very itchy. But these patients are not feeling the, however it is a more severe form, but patient is not feeling the itch over there because the nerves has been damaged. So these are the neuropathic patients. They're having the neuropathy, so they're having the decreased sensation due to neuropathy. That's why they are not able to feel the itch over there. Okay, so that's why. So immunocompromised patient, as I said, for example HIV can be there, leprosy patients can be there. Okay, so that's why pruritus component is decreasing over there. Itchy, they are not able to feel the itch over there. Okay, so that's why. And mites can be actually replicating in that particular area for about millions and millions, because the patient is not scratching at all, and the scabies, which is the sarcoptic scabie mite, they're not moving from the surface. So they're just replicating themselves in the stratum corneum, making a serpiginous tunnel over there and getting worse and worse. That's why it's the most severe form. The patient is not feeling the itch also, and the sarcoptic scabies are moving, okay, very nicely in the skin surface, right? So it is also called as the crusted scabies, guys. It is also called as the crusted scabies, okay, because the patient will be having the crusted kind of lesions. Okay, it is also called as a crusted scabies, right? And here you can see the Norwegian scabies. Here you can see the crusted lesions, isn't it? Here you can see the crusted lesions, right? Person will not be feeling the itch over there, and the sarcoptic scabie will be replicating very nicely on the skin surface, the stratum corneum, destroying everything over there. This is the sarcoptic scabie, right? Okay, Norwegian scabies, most severe form, done about that as well. Okay, and the patient will be having usually, you know, very I would say the hyperkeratotic. You can see very thick skin over there. Thick skin means very thick skin over here. So I would say that this is the hyperkeratotic crusted lesions. Okay, if I'm saying there was a crusted lesions, they will be the hyperkeratotic. Okay, hyperkeratosis is there, hyperkeratotic. Thickening of the stratum corneum basically is called as a hyperkeratosis, because stratum corneum is involved, as I said, that in the stratum corneum, through that they will be making the serpiginous tunnel, right? So hyperkeratotic crusted lesions will be found over there. Okay, very commonly, where they are found, very commonly, if you talk about the site, then very commonly they can be seen on the trunk, palm, salt region, right? So these are the basic sites over there. So what are the sites, if you talk about? So sites over there, they can be trunk region, soles and palm region. Okay, so this can be the common sites. However, it can be occurring in other sites also, right? Okay, what about the treatment, guys, as far as this particular thing is concerned? What about the treatment basically of the Norwegian? We can give ivermectin as far as systemic treatment is concerned. We can give ivermectin. Obviously, we need to try systemic one, ivermectin. Permethrin you can apply over there, fine. Permethrin you can apply, ivermectin, permethrin. But the hyperkeratosis is there, stratum corneum became so thick, so we need to enter also, because permethrin 5% you will be applying on the skin surface, it will not be able to go and just pierce the stratum corneum. It will not be able to do that because hyperkeratosis is there, very thick stratum corneum is there. So if you want the action of permethrin, you need to make the skin thinner. How you will be making the skin thinner over there? Then we need to introduce one agent over there, that is the keratolytic agent, because hyperkeratosis is there, so we need to make the skin thinner now. So we need to introduce the keratolytic agent now. Keratolytic agent. Now what are you talking about, man? What is a keratolytic agent? Basically, we need to introduce the salicylic acid. Okay, salicylic acid. With the help of salicylic acid, okay, yes, salicylic acid, you heard it right. With the help of salicylic acid, we are making it thinner. We are making the skin thinner, and that's how the permethrin now can go beneath the stratum corneum layer and can work on the sarcoptic scabie. Basically, how it is working permethrin, it is paralyzing the sarcoptic scabie, and that's why sarcoptic scabie is not able to further replicate, and that's how the patient will be healing afterwards. Right, so that is the case over there. Now first one was the infantile scabies I have talked about, second one is the Norwegian scabies, okay, and third one I'm gonna talk about, that is the nodular scabies. Okay, so nodular scabies, guys. Okay, nodular scabies. If you talk about the nodular scabies, what is the basic thing about the nodular scabies? It is happening more commonly in the scrotal region or in the axilla region, okay, basically in the fold region. So scrotum or axilla, very commonly it is involved. It is a hypersensitivity response to the scabies mite, to the sarcoptic scabie. Okay, so most commonly I will be seeing the nodules in the axilla region, either in the axilla region or in the scrotum region, commonly. Okay, how we are treating that, basically, how we are treating them, then obviously anti-scabbing agent. So for example, permethrin 5%. Okay, permethrin can be given, for example, right? Or with that, along with that, sometimes steroids, if it is not non-responding, then intralesional, in these nodules we need to inject some steroids over there. Okay, so intralesional steroids can also be used. As you can see over here on the skin, this is a scrotum. On the scrotum surface, on the scrotal surface, here you can see the nodular scabies, right? Nodular scabies, right? So nodular scabies you can find over there. Okay, fine. So we have talked about the scabies. Now let's check our knowledge over the scabies topic. So very first question, guys, a 37-year-old patient with a history of SLE. Okay, with a history of SLE. Fine. Okay, with a history of SLE in the patient. Patient was taking prednisolone, methotrexate, present to the dermatology clinic with 3 weeks of diffuse itchy rash. Okay, physical examination is remarkable for small red papules in her bilateral axillae and groin. Okay, and there are the reddish brown lines in her interdigital spaces. Which of the following is the most effective treatment? Before the treatment, we need to make the diagnosis first of all. What is the diagnosis, guys? Very easy, no problem with that. Many hints are given over here. First of all, they said history, there is a itchy rash. Okay, first one. Second one, they have talked about the location, small red papules. I told you ascorated papules can be there. Okay, where is the location? I told you circle of Habra. Easily you can remember. Web spaces can be involved, axilla region, groin region, okay, and the genital region and all. Circle of Habra you can easily remember. So axillae are involved over there, groin region is involved, reddish brown lines in the interdigital spaces, that is a web spaces that is involved. So diagnosis is very clear in our mind, that is a scabies for sure, and the itch mite that is involved, Sarcoptes scabie var hominis, right? So what are the following treatment should be given? So hydrocortisone cream we are not giving, obviously nystatin cream we are not giving in the scabies, permethrin 5% cream topically we are giving, definitely we are giving that. So answer over here, according to me, that should be the permethrin 5% cream, isn't it? Permethrin 5% cream should be used over there. Okay, permethrin 5% cream should be used over here. Next question, topically 5%, right? So next question, 19-year-old college student presents to the emergency department. Okay, so 19-year college student presents to the emergency department complaining of an itchy rash on her hands and in her groin region for 2 days. The itching worse at night. So I told you guys, nocturnal itch, if you remember. The patient has traveled recently for spring break to South America, London and Spain. She went hunting while on vacation and hunted animals including rabbits, deer, foxes. Participated in rabbit taxidermy course as well during this time. Temperature 36.1 degrees Celsius, BP is fine, pulse is fine, respiration 12 per minute, oxygen saturation fine, 98%, physical examination notable for finding in the figure A. So it is given in the figure A. And which of the following is the most appropriate treatment? First of all, before the treatment, we need to make the diagnosis, right? So here you can see in the web spaces, interdigital spaces, you can see easily, okay, you can see easily the papules over there. Okay, so ascorated papules are there. So what should be the treatment, guys, over here? Yes, definitely, you are right. That is the, among the given option, permethrin 5% should be given, obviously, right? Topically, you should apply over there. Fine, so that is about, again, the diagnosis was scabies. Right, so that again the diagnosis was your scabies, right? So guys, that was about the short discussion for the scabies topic. I hope you liked it, and if you want these kind of videos in future also, please let me know in the comment section. So thank you so much for watching this one, and I will see you in the next one very soon. Bye bye, take care.